Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture we are going to learn the next concept in the chapter decimal. The concept is comparison of decimal. As we have seen in the first chapter, comparison of numbers. Okay, so in that way we can compare the two decimals also. Okay, so how to compare decimals? See here, there are two types of decimals, like decimals and unlike decimals. Like decimals means what? The decimals having same number of decimal places. Okay, suppose here 0.7 and 0.9, 0.28, 0.57, 6.357, 25.285. Okay, so if you observe these two decimals, see here, after decimal point, how many places are there? Here one, and in this here also one. Okay, in these two decimals, after decimal point, how many places are there? Here two, and here also two. In these decimal numbers, after decimal point, how many decimal places are there? 3 here, also 3. Okay, so when the two decimals are called like decimals, when their decimal places are same, okay, means see, in these two, here decimal place is 1 and here also decimal place is 1. Decimal place means the places after decimal point. Okay, so here also 1, here also 1, that means they are like decimals. Similarly here, see, after decimal point 2 places are there. Here also after decimal point 2 places are there. That means these two decimals, 0.28 and 0.57, are like decimals. Okay, again see here, 6.357, in this decimal 3 decimal places are there, and here also 3 decimal places are there. So these two decimal numbers are like decimals. Understand? Opposite of these, the two decimals having different decimal places, they are called unlike decimal. For example, suppose here there is 0.7 and here there is 0.92. Then see these two decimals, are they like? No, they are not like decimals because their decimal places are not same. Here 1 and here 2, decimal places are different, so they are unlike. Again see one more example, suppose 0.28 and 0.573, here 2 decimal places, here 3 decimal places. Decimal places are not same, so they are unlike decimals. Correct? Again 6.35 and 25.285. See here there are 2 decimal places, here there are 3 decimal places. Okay, so these are also not like decimals. That is unlike decimals. Okay, so as I told you, like decimals means the decimals, two or more decimals having same decimal places, equal decimal places. Okay, and unlike decimals means the decimals having different number of decimal places or not equal. Okay, so these are unlike decimals, these are like decimals. So when we are going to compare two decimals, we are going to compare in this way, like decimals and unlike decimals. Okay, so see here, these are unlike decimals, but the fact is, you know, these unlike decimals we can convert into like decimals. We can make their decimal places same, we can convert them into like decimals. Which way? By putting 0 at the end. Means what? See here, in this first example, 0.7, 0.92, here there are 2 decimal places, here there is 1 decimal place. So to make them like decimals, what we have to do? In both the decimals, there should be two decimal places. Okay. Now here there are two, here there is one. So here we need to add one decimal place so that there will become two decimal places and they will become live decimals. Then we will add zero at the end. Okay. So here we put zero. So here became 0.70 and here 0.92. Now they are like decimals. Okay, that means what I want to tell you is, unlike decimals, if the decimals are unlike, we can convert them into like decimals. Okay, so see here also, see 0.28 and 0.573, two decimal places, three decimal places. We, if you want to make them like decimals, then where will you put zero in which decimal? First. Okay, here we will put zero at the end. So now there are three decimal places. They are like now. Here also, see, here we will put zero so that here will become three decimal places, and here also there are three decimal places now. So they are like now. Remember, when we put zero at the end, their value, when its value, when it was only one place, 0.7, at that time its value, whatever its value is there, when we put zero, it doesn't change. Its value remain as it is. Value doesn't change. Just we have added one decimal place by putting zero. Okay, not any other digit. We cannot put any other digit except zero. Understand? So when we put zero, our decimal places increase and value also doesn't change. Understand? This is the benefit of putting zero at the end. So now they are like decimals. Why I told you to why I have taught you this, that we should convert unlike decimals to like decimals, because when we are going to compare two decimals, when we are going to compare two decimals, at that time we if the two decimals are like decimals, we can compare easily. If the two decimals are like decimals, then we can compare easily. But when the two decimals are unlike, when the two decimals are unlike, in that case we have to convert them first into like decimals and then we have to compare. Okay, so now see here, let us learn the comparison. Now we know that these are like decimals, these are unlike decimals. Okay, these are like decimals. So like decimals we can compare very easily, as I told you. Compare means what? Greater than, less than, or equal to. Correct? Now see, 0.7 and 0.9, when they are like decimals, when they are like decimals, directly see here, in the whole part, see, before decimal there is 0, in the whole part there is 0, here also 0. Okay, so see the without considering decimal point, which number we can see here? 0.7 means 7, and here 0.9 means 9. And in 7 and 9, which is greater? 9 is greater. So 7 is less than 9. So 0.7 is less than 0.9. Okay, when they are like decimals, it's very easy. As usual, we have to compare. Here see, 0.28 and 0.57. So without considering decimal point, we get this number as a 28. As whole part is 0, so, and here 57, and so 28 and 57, between these two numbers, which is greater? 57, correct? So 28 is less than 57, that is 0.28 is less than 0.57. okay, so in this way we can compare the like decimals whose whole part is 0, 0. Understand? Now see here, whole part, they are like decimals, but they have whole part something. Here there is 6, here 25. So in this case, just compare their whole part. Here 6 and 25. Whole number part, you know, the part before decimal point is called whole number part. Okay, so when it has whole number part other than 0, just compare that. Okay, 6 and here 25. Which is greater? Obviously 25. So 6.357 is less than 25.285. Okay, if it is same, if whole number part is same, then compare the decimal part. Okay. Now here see, they are unlike decimals. So when we are going to compare unlike decimals, first what I have told you to do? First we have to convert them into like decimals. Now see here 0.7, 0.92, here two decimal places are there, here only one. So to make them like, put 0 here. Understand? And as whole part is 00, just compare the decimal part, here 70 and 92. Which is greater? 92 is greater, so 0.70 is less than 0.92. Okay? Here also see 0.28, 0.573. Now they are unlike decimals, so first we have to convert them into like decimals. Okay, so here we'll put 10, so now they are like decimals. Then their whole part is 00, so compare their decimal part, 280 and 573, which is greater? 573. 280 is less than the 573, so 0.280 is less than 0.573. Now here as usual like that, but before that make them like. Okay, and 6 and 25, it has whole parts, 25 is greater, so this is greater. Understand? In this way we have to compare two decimals. If they are like, it's very easy to compare. If they are unlike, first we need to convert them into like decimals and then we have to compare. So the question will be asked to compare the two decimals or ascending order, arrange the decimals into ascending order, arrange the decimals into descending order. This is also one kind of comparison. Understand? So now let's solve the practice 8.3, which is based on this comparison of decimals. Let's solve practice 8.3. See your first question. Question first, which of the following pairs of decimals are like decimals? So here some pair of decimals are given, we have to identify which are like decimals and which are unlike. Okay, so in front of like decimals we will write like decimals, and in front of those who are not like, in front of them we will write unlike decimals. Now see here, first one, 0.3 and 1.3. as I told you, like decimals means what? The decimals having same decimal places. Decimal places means the places after decimal point. Okay, so here see, after decimal point here 1, here also 1, same decimal places, so they are like decimals. Okay, next 0.3, one decimal place here, and 0.03, two decimal places, are they like? No, they are unlike. Okay, next 2.7, 3.77, year 1, year 2, are they like or unlike? They are unlike, not decimal places are not same. Okay, so they are unlike. Here 0.7, 0.76, year 1 decimal place, year 2 decimal places, so they are not like, that is they are unlike. Okay, next 400.50, two decimal places, 400.05, two decimal places, decimal places are same, correct? So they are like decimals. You see last one, 117.07 and 119.07. Again see here, decimal places are 2, 2, same. So they are like decimals. Understand? So in short, decimal like decimals means what? The such decimals whose decimal places are equal. Okay? And decimal places are not equal, then they are unlike decimals. Okay? So when we are going to compare two decimals, or when we are going to arrange the decimals into ascending or descending order, first we have to check whether they are like decimals or unlike. And if they are unlike decimals, first we have to convert them into like decimals. Okay. Now see here question number 2. put greater than, less than or equal to sign in the boxes. Means we have to compare. Understand? Let's see. 0.5 and 0.2. First check whether they are like, means their decimal places are same. Here see, one decimal place, here also one decimal place, means they are like. Now see, here whole part is 0 in both the decimal part, that is here 5 and 2. In 5 and 2, which is greater? 5, correct? That means 0.5 is greater than 0.2. Understand? Next. 0.073 and 0.14. Now see, are they like decimals? No, they are unlike decimals. So when there are unlike decimals, first what we have to do? We have to convert them into like decimals. So here 3 decimal places are there in this first, and here 2. So here we have to add 10 at the end. Now we have to compare. Whole part is 00. So just compare the decimal part. Here 073. 073 means nothing but 73 only. 73, and here 140. So which is greater, 73 or 140? 140 is greater. That means 0.073 is less than 0.140. Understand? Next. 0.5 and 0.50. Are they like decimals? Are the decimal places same? No. First, means they are unlike, so convert them into like decimals. Here there are 2 decimal places, so, and here 1. So we need to add 0 here at the end. Understand? Again see, here whole part 0, whole part 0. So compare their decimal part. So here in the first decimal 50 and here also 50. Means they are equal. So 0.50 is equal to 0.50. Got it? 0.69 and 0.63. They are like decimals as their decimal places are 2, 2, same. And see now, let's compare here 0, whole part is 0. So just compare the decimal part, okay? That is 69 and 63. Which is greater? 69 is greater. So 0.69 is greater than 0.63. Got it? 4.32, 7.02. Are the decimal places same? Fine. Same. They are like decimals. Now we can compare. Now see here, whole part of this decimal number is there other than 0. So here there is 4, here 7. Which is greater? 7 or 4? 7. 7 is greater. That means 4.32 is less than the 7.02. Not need to compare other digits when the whole part is other than 0. Okay? 3.07, 3.70. Again, decimal places are same. They are like decimals. So we can compare now. See, whole part here 3, here 3. Whole part is same. See, whole part is same. So check the decimal part here 0770. 07 means only 7, and here 70 means 70. Okay, so 70 is greater. That means 3.07 is less than the 3.70. Got it? So in this way, we have to compare two decimals. If they are like, we can compare directly. If they are unlike, first we need to convert them into like decimals, and then we have to compare. Okay? Now pause this video and write these examples in your notebook. In this second question, there are 3 more examples. Try by yourself. Understand? Let's see now ascending and descending order of decimals. Okay, how to arrange the decimals into descending or ascending order. It is ascending order and descending order. It is one kind of comparison only. So the rules which we have used for comparison, same rules we have to apply here. First, we have to check whether all the decimals are like decimals or not. If they are not like decimals or they are unlike decimals, then first we have to convert them into like decimals and then we have to compare. Now let's see here first one. Question number 3 is arrange the given decimals into ascending order, smallest to greatest. So here see first 0.60, 0.41, 0.06, 0.04, 0.14. Sorry, here 0.6. Okay. Now see, here 0.6, 0.41. In all the decimals, there are two places except this first one. Understand? So, what we will do, here also we will make two places by putting 0 at the end. Understand? So, see here, in all decimals, there are two decimal places. Means they are now like decimals. So, let's compare. See the whole parts. In all decimals, whole part is 0. So simply we have to compare the decimal part. So 60, 41, 06 means 6, 04 means 4 and 40. In this, which is smallest? Very small is this, 04. Understand? And the second number, 6. Correct? Then 60, 41, 40. Which is smaller? 40. 60 and 41. Between these two, 41 is smaller. So this will come at 4th position. And 60 is greatest. This will come at 5th position. Okay, let's write 0.04, 0.06, then 0.14, 0.41. And 0.60. Got it? Next. 0.15, 0.63, 0.6, 0.07 and 0.7. So here, in this and this decimal, there is only one decimal place, whereas in other three, there are two decimal places. So what we will do here, we will put 0. Now they are like decimals. So now we can compare. Again, see the whole part is 0, 0, 0, 0. So simply compare the decimal part. Now see, 15, 63, 60, 07 is 7 and 70. Which is smaller, smallest, very small? 07, because 07 is 7, okay? Then 15, correct? Then 63, 60, 70. 60. Then between 63 and 70, 63. Correct? And 70 is the greatest, so it will come in the last position. So 0.07, 0.15, 0.60, 0.63, and 0.70. Understand? Next question number 4, arrange into descending order. Same, first we have to check whether all decimals are like or not. If they are not like decimals, first we have to convert them into like decimals by adding 0 in the last. Now here see two decimal places. Here there is one, okay, and here. So now their decimal places are 2, 2. So now we can compare them. Here see we have to find greatest decimal first. Understand? Biggest. See they have whole part other than zeros. 1, 6, 6, 1, 0 and 0. So in this whole part 2 times 1 is there, 2 times 6 is there and 2 times 0. Greatest is 6, correct? But there are 2 times 6, 6.02 and 6.10. So in this case, we will compare their decimal part. 02 and 10, which is greatest? 10, correct? So this will come first, this will come second. Now remain 1, 1 and 0, 0. So 1 is greater than 0, but there is 2 times 1. So we will compare their decimal part, 37 and 40. So 40 is greatest, so it will come at 3rd position and this will come at 4th position. And here 0.91, 0.80, okay, so 91 and 80, which is greatest? 91, so this is 5th, this is 6, very small, okay, so let's write 6.10, second 6.02, 1.40, 1.37, 0.91 and 0.80. Next, see last one. Here there was no zero. Now see 1.98, 0.46, 0.6, 0.09, 2.17 and 2.3. So where there is only one decimal place, we will put 0 here and here. So that now they are like decimals. Let's check their whole part. 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2. 2 times 2, 1 times 1 and 3 times 0. Greatest is 2, correct? But there is 2 times 2, so we will check their decimal part. Here 17, here 30. Which is greatest? 30. And 17 is smaller, so it will come in the second place, okay? Then remain 1 and 0, 0, 0. So 1 is greatest, so it will come at third position. Then 3 times 0 is there. So in that, we will check the decimal parts. 46, 60 and 9. 0, 9 is 9. Greatest is 60. So this will come at 4th. 46. And 9 is the smallest, so this will come at 6th position, okay? So let's write 2.30, 2.17, 1.98, 4th 0.60, 5th 0.46, 0.09, okay? So in this way we can arrange the decimals into ascending and descending order. Remember, first, if they are not like decimals, all decimal numbers are not like, then we have to make them like by adding 0 at the end. Understand? So and then we can arrange them into ascending and descending order. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this comparison of decimals, you can ask me. So thank you for today and have a nice day.